Hey there, you probably thought I was done with the entire Metal Gear Solid series. But no, there's still one game I want to talk about. Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker. And my favorite character from this game would of course be a male character because the previous video it was a female character. I feel like this is a cop-out. But, you know, there's a lot of interesting characters in Peace Walker, but none to me really stands out as much as this character, and you play as him, Big Boss. Peace Walker is finally the game where we see this transformation happen. Transformation from Naked Snake to Big Boss. At the end of the game, when he gives that speech, oh my god, that brings chill to my spine. Like, when he finally tells Miller, don't call me Snake anymore, call me Big Boss. Just like, holy shit, this is finally happening. He's finally becoming Big Boss. He's finally becoming that, you know, this is it. This is when it happens. At the beginning of that. The momentum of that was so awesome. That's why seeing the Ground Zero trailer and seeing Phantom Pain trailer, that's what got me so excited. Because now we finally see this transformation fully take place. And Peace Walker, like, Big Boss finally comes to grip with his idea of the boss's will. So he's finally come to have his own interpretation of the boss, which in the end turns out to pretty much turn the world upside down because it begins a fight against Zero and the Patriots. So, yeah, that's pretty much why, just seeing his transformation. David Hayter's voice acting, I think, was the strongest in Peace Walker than in any other game, a Metal Gear Solid game. I think he did a fantastic job voice acting as the Big Boss in Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker, which is quite something, because I know Peace Walker is not even a numbered Metal Gear Solid title, but it really, in that way, because of his performance, it felt like Metal Gear Solid 5. I would not have had any gripe with Kojima if he called Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker Metal Gear Solid 5. I would be perfectly fine with that. It's a really great game. It tells a lot of the story after Metal Gear Solid 3. In a way, I can understand why it's not a number title. It's kind of a standalone title. It doesn't really connect with all the other Metal Gear Solid games much at all. So in that sense, I can understand. But damn, the quality of the writing, the quality of the voice acting. This is really awesome stuff here. It's a shame that it's a PSP game, not because I don't like the PSP, not because I don't think it was a great game on the PSP, but because that's why not a lot of people have played it. You know, if this was released on the PS3, I think it would have been more widespread, or if it was on multi-platform. It would have been pretty cool to have more people have experienced this game so that it's more widely discussed in the gaming public. And so that, you know, there's a lot of people who, a lot of comments I see on you know, videos of YouTube upload of the Phantom Pain trailer or the Grand Juris trailer. And the comments, like, I see them, it's just like, oh my gosh, these people have no idea what's going on in this trailer because they have not played Peace Walker. They have no idea what's going on in this trailer. If you play Peace Walker, you would have a lot of ideas. Like, you would get it. It's just like, oh, yeah. You would know why it's so exciting, you know, to see these trailers. So that's the shame, you know. More people should play Peace Walker, simply because it's awesome. It tells the story of how Naked Snake, finally becomes Big Boss, or the beginning process of that. And this beginning process is super necessary. It's something that, you know, when a character that you know is going to turn out this way, but you start at this beginning point. This transition period, I think, is really important. I'm going to talk about Star Wars Episode 3 for a moment. How Anakin Skywalker turned into Darth Vader. Transition in that movie didn't exist. And that's why that movie was fun to watch. But for me, that was like the biggest reason why Episode 3 was kind of a failure. That transition, it was not even there. Looks Anakin Skywalker just like, okay, I'm Darth Vader now. That's what it felt like. With Peace Walker, that transition is there, and it's pretty awesome to see. It's so subtle and gradual. in a way. And it's not even, it's the transformation hasn't fully taken place either. Why Big Boss becomes this gruntled person so against the United States government that eventually Big Boss ends up creating a terrorist base that threatens the entire world with the nuclear arsenal. How does that happen? That Peace Walker is the beginning, and it's so awesome to see. That's not to say, you know, Peace Walker didn't have any other awesome characters. Big Boss is definitely, is he the most important character in Peace Walker? Could be arguable. Miller was definitely important. Zero is definitely important, although he's not even, you know, he's not even voiced in the game, but he's there in the background of the game story. A lot of interesting characters. Huey's interesting, which he's like Otacon's grandfather, so that's pretty interesting to see, and he, you know, and him also having this awkward kind of personality. I didn't find Huey as strong as someone like Otacon though. He's just kind of there as fan service. Doctor Strangelove was totally interesting character. Paz was a bit too much, you know, just kind of too unrealistic to me. It kind of broke me out of the universe just because of how odd Paz was. But, oh my gosh, Zadornov, I think that was his name. Great character. That's how you make a villain, again. So, Peace Walker had really interesting cast of characters, but Big Boss just stands out. Like, I'm playing as him, I'm seeing him transform, his speeches, like, it finally gives you the chills. David Hayter's voice acting in this game just adds that extra element of awesomeness and badassery. Man, this Peace Walker was definitely a game for the fans. Fans of the story and Mythos, even though it's a totally standalone story. So in that regard, like, I just knowing that this is Big Boss's story, that's what makes me really like Big Boss. Big Boss is one of the most interesting characters in the gaming world because of his transformations, because of his ideals, because of his interpretation of the boss's will. You know, when it comes to question of, this is a very difficult question that a lot of people bring up, like Big Boss or Solid Snake, which do you like more? And I think it's because of the attachment that I grew with playing as Solid Snake as a kid, as a teenager. It's probably why I tend to prefer Solid Snake. Also, he's relatable in the sense that he's always manipulated. Big Boss is really great to get attached to his disloyal sense of ideals, but he's just broken. You know, after the boss's death, he's a broken character. Not broken character as saying like he's a horrible character, but he's a character that is actually, as a person, not broken. He's doing things that he doesn't really believe in anymore, but he just kind of is struggling to find that belief in himself, in the world he lives in. He's restructuring or refiguring things out. He never is able to do that. And the moment that he does is when he dies. He's finally able to figure things out on the graveyard. Whereas Solid Snake, he has a lot of moments of clarity, and we can really relate to him in how he reacts to the situation to his. So I feel like even though Solid Snake is actually a clone and Big Boss is the original human being, I feel like Solid Snake in that manner feels more human, especially in Metal Gear Solid 4, because you see his pain, you feel his pain, he's just physically deteriorating and he's just pushing forward. That was an amazing thing. So I guess this is a whole other topic altogether. Big Boss versus Solid Snake. Maybe that's a comment I'll leave up to you. Which do you like more, Big Boss or Solid Snake? And maybe share your reason if you have any. So if you want to leave any comment, leave that comment. That's my video on Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker. I think I'm pretty much done with talking about Metal Gear Solid in this series as a franchise. I don't think I'm going to pick any character out of Metal Gear 1 or Metal Gear 2. Maybe I might talk about Portable Ops, but I'm not too sure about that. I might be done. So next video, it's not going to be a Metal Gear game, I promise you. And next video, it's going to be a female character.